Hello everyone, today we will talk about vasoplegia syndrome. What is vasoplegia? It's a syndrome of pathological low systemic vascular resistance. Let's say losing vascular tone. The dominant clinical feature of this issue is hypotension in the presence of low or high cardiac output. The systemic vascular resistance means the difference between arterial pressure and the venous pressure to the cardiac output. Let's say systemic vascular resistance SVR is equal to mean arterial pressure minus the right atrial pressure, that means the venous pressure, divided by cardiac output. Vasoplegia we can see in many clinical scenarios like septic shock, post cardiac bypass and after surgery, burns and trauma, etc. Patients in hospitals most commonly experience vasoplegia from general or neuroaxial anesthesia. Next, we will see the causes of vasoplegia. Let's see in sepsis. The commonest cause of vasoplegia in critical care is sepsis. As we all know, the cytokine release and synthesis of nitric oxide during sepsis will cause vasodilation and hypotension. The most recent definition of sepsis does not require persistent hypotension. However, we can see the administration of vasopressors to maintain the mean arterial pressure above 65 and high blood lactate level in sepsis. Next is cardiac surgery. This is the second commonest cause of vasoplegia. The diagnosis is more complex here. Why? Because the risk of presence of impaired cardiac output due to bleeding and compromise the myocardial contractility and the occurrence of cardiac turbinate. And the second most complicating factor is frequent use of vasodilators. Then the non-cardiac surgery. It is rare, but there are risk factors such as prolonged surgery, blood loss, exposure to general anesthesia and neuroaxial blockade such as epidural analgesia. Other causes like burns, trauma and pancreatitis. These are the conditions by significant tissue injury with the consequent hypermetabolism, systemic inflammatory response and the predisposition to the development of organ dysfunction. Let's have some idea about the physiology behind this. The systemic vascular resistance is determined by changes in the arteriolar diameter, controlled by the contractile activity of the vascular smooth muscle cells in the tunica media. Here it is, the third structure in the arterial wall cross section. The vascular tone is regulated through intracellular calcium ion concentration. The vascular smooth muscle contraction is driven by a rise in systolic calcium ion concentration through release of stored calcium ion from the sarcoplasmic reticulum as well as extracellular calcium ion influx through voltage sensitive channels. Relaxation of vascular smooth muscle cell is driven by a fall in systolic calcium ion. Due to uptake of calcium ion by the sarcoplasmic reticulum and expulsion of potassium ion through their channels into the extracellular space, resulting in cellular hyperpolarization and vasodilation. Vascular tone is therefore dependent on the rate of calcium ion influx versus removal, which in turn is regulated by intrinsic and extrinsic mechanism. Here we can see if the calcium ion concentration is decreasing by moving the potassium ion out and it is blocking the calcium ion intake, so there will be vasodilation. And the next picture, if the concentration of calcium ion is getting up, so there will be a vasoconstriction. So the intrinsic regulators. The first one is endothelial secretions like nitric oxide, prostacycline, endothelin, and autocoids such as serotonin, prostaglandins, and thromboxane A2. And the third one is vasoactive metabolites, such as acidosis, hypoxia, and hydrogen peroxide. Look at the extrinsic regulators, like catecholamine resistance, corticosteroid response, endogenous vasopressin. So, to conclude, whenever we are getting a patient with persistent hypertension and not responding to the fluid or the absence of hypovolemia, with the high or normal cardiac output, we have to suspect vasoplegia and take necessary action to maintain the mean arterial pressure above 65. I hope you enjoy my class. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.